Let's solve a coding question.
Okay, let's go.
Alright, for this coding question, our data consists of information about 30 employees of a given company, and our goal would be to find the second highest salary in this small data set. Now, we only need to return the value of this second highest salary, and we are going to solve it using four different approaches. For the first approach, I'm going to use lists, and this approach would only work because we are only interested in the value of the second highest earning. If we were interested in the information of any other columns, this approach would not be a suitable one. Let's say that we have the values in the column salary, and then I create a list out of these values, and after that I'm going to sort them in ascending order. Now, the value at index minus 1 will be the highest value or the highest earning, and the element at index minus 2 would be the second highest earning. Okay, I'm going to begin by creating a list of all the values in the salary column. Let's also sort it. This will be automatically in ascending order, so we do not need to do anything else here. The answer lies in the second index from the end of the list. So that's what we are going to look for. It's 200,000 and it's actually correct. For the second approach, let's say that we have already sorted our results based on the salary column, as you can see here. Now, it's going to be as easy as this. We are going to choose the second element from the top, which is going to be the element at index 1. So this value is going to be the element at index 0. This value will be the element at index 1. And that is going to be our answer to this question. I'm going to begin here by sorting the values based on the salary column. Now, this is going to be automatically in ascending order because I want my results in descending order. I need to change that. Let's look at it. So this is what we were looking for. Now we have sorted based on the salary column, and we are looking for this value, and only we want this column. So I'm going to first limit it only on the salary column, and then I'm going to return the second value from the top, which is at index 1. And that again is our solution, and it's correct. Now the third approach is very similar to the second one, we just use different commands for it. What we are going to do here is that we are going to return the top two values using n largest, and after that I'm going to return the tail of these two, which is going to be the value at bottom. This one is going to be really concise. I just need the salary column and I want the two largest values. Let's first look at them, and between these two I want the lower one, or the value at the bottom, which is going to be here at tail 1, and I'm going to return it. It's again the 200,000, and it's the correct solution. We can also check for it again. It's correct.
Wait a minute. Stop.
Let's say that our data set only consisted of these four rows. Now, the top two earnings are the same. So if we use any of these three approaches and look for the second value, then it would actually mislead us. It's the same as the top value or the top earning. If the question had explicitly asked us about the second highest unique value, then these approaches would not have given us the correct answer. You could have optimized them a little bit, like by the first approach, instead of using a list, you could have used a set. Or by the second and the third approaches, one could begin by first dropping the duplicate values from the earnings and then go on with the rest of the approach. However, there is also one other nice solution for that. Let's say that we want to rank these data based on the earnings. So that means that I have the earnings and I want to assign ranks to them. and I want to assign them in a way that the same values receive the same rank, like here, and then the next value will receive the next rank, and there will be no gaps in the rankings. And this will go on up until the end of the list. And at the end, I can just look for the second rank and find the earning that I am actually looking for. Let's begin by creating a new column. Let's call it rankings, for which we are going to use the data from the salary column, and we want to rank them. Now, whenever we want to rank some data, we need to specify a method. What the method does is that it defines how the ranking will be done, and we will here pass dense as the method because it's the ranking that we are looking for. The same values will get the same rank, and there will be no gaps in the rankings. And because I want to do this in descending order, I'm going to set ascending to false. I just now need to look for the row or the rows where these rankings is equal to 2. Let's first have a look at it. We get this row, and because I'm only interested in the salary column, I'm going to limit my results on that. And as you can see, again, we get to the correct answer. Now with that, this tutorial comes to an end. I will share the link to the codes in the captions of this video. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you in my next tutorial.